This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to do some basic drug calculations that require manipulating fractions. So here's the first problem. This one says that the order is for 1/2 grain, and that the scored tablets on hand contain 1/5 grain. We want to know how many tablets are given. Okay, so we'll start out with the order. That was 1/2 grain. We'll make that whole thing a fraction over 1. And we know we want to end up with tablets, so we'll put that unit over here on the right, tablets. And we're told that the tablets are scored and they contain 1/5 grain. So I'm going to take my first fraction and multiply it by the fraction 1 tablet over 1/5 grain. Well, I can cancel out the grains. That'll be nice, because then I'll be left with nothing but tablets, and I want tablets as my answer. When I multiply the numerators, I get 1/2 times 1 tablet. So that's going to be 1/2. I've got tablets written in already. That 1/2, that fraction, is the numerator of another fraction, 1 times 1/5, which is what happens when I multiply the denominators. Now, I know this looks kind of scary, 1/2 over 1/5, but let's remember how to deal with fractions. We take that 1/2 over 1/5, we think of it as 1/2 divided by 1/5. When we have a problem involving division of two fractions, we can rewrite the problem as multiplication. The first fraction remains the same, so we still have 1/2. But instead of a division sign, we'll use a multiplication sign. And then the second fraction is going to get flipped upside down. So instead of 1/5, we'll have 5 over 1. Now I can multiply 1/2 times 5 over 1. I multiply the numerators. 1 times 5 is 5. Then I multiply the denominators, 2 times 1 is 2, and I get 5 over 2, which we can convert into a mixed number. We could either think of it as a decimal, 2.5, but in this case, since we're dealing with things like tablets, we might want to make it into 2.5 tablets. Okay? So what we did was we took the order and put that first over on the left. We took the units we wanted to end up with and put that on the right. We took the fraction that we have to multiply with. In this case, it was 1 tablet over 1/5 grain. And then we do the multiplication. The only thing different about this than a lot of basic problems is that we have to deal with these fractions. And then we use the rules for dealing with fractions. That you take the division problem, turn it to a multiplication problem. Okay, let's do one more. This one says the order reads 1/400 grain, and that we've got a vial labeled 1/300 grain is the same as 20 drops. We want to know how many drops are to be given. So let's start with the order. That's 1/400 grain. And I'll put that over 1. At the right side of the equation, I want to remind myself that I'm dealing with drops. And then we know that 1/300 grain equals 20 drops. So I'll take my first fraction and multiply it by 20 drops over 1/300 grain. So the grains are going to cancel again. And let's make a little more room. I'm going to be left multiplying across. I've got 1 over 400 times 20. So that's 20 over 400. That's drops. The denominator is going to be this fraction 1 over 300. So I've got 20 over 400 divided by 1 over 300. Let's write that as division. 20 over 400 divided by 1 over 300. We'll turn that into a multiplication problem. 20 over 400 times 300 over 1. Since I've got 300 and 400, I'm going to cancel out the hundreds. So I just make the 300 into a 3 and the 400 into a 4. And I've got a 20 over 4. Well, I can divide both of those numbers by 4. 20 divided by 4 is 5. And 4 divided by 4 is 1. So my denominators are just 1, so I can just multiply the numerators. That's 5 times 3. So I'm going to get 15. And that's drops. Okay, so not as hard as they seem. You might want to practice these so that you're not too surprised by them when you end up with one on a test. Take care. I'll see you next time.